Today's gonna look good with the frame around it. Like a dream come true, so glad we found it. Sunshine through the window pane. Hear music when you speak my name. There's a rhythm of a life here in the moment. So let's own it. It's gonna be a good day. It's gonna be a good night. It's gonna be a good day with you by my side. All we gotta do is wake up. All we gotta do is wake up now. That's a bottle we can shake up. Shake it up, pass it all around. It's gonna be a good day. Gonna be a good night. So let's light this night like a Roman candle. And you look so perfect, I can't stand it anymore. I'll spin you around these stars. Close enough, I can feel your heart. The rhythm of a life here in the moment. So let's own it. It's gonna be a good day. It's gonna be a good night. It's gonna be a good day with you by my side. All we gotta do is wake up. All we gotta do is wake up now. Life's a bottle that we shake up. Shake it up, pass it all around. It's gonna be a good day. It's gonna be a good night. Gonna be a good night.
Don't fall down the steps.
Right out of Hollywood.
Got hat. Yowl.
You may be seated.
Welcome each and all to this vow renewal ceremony for Julie and Rodney's 25th wedding anniversary. My name is Ed Wagner. I'm the brother of the bride. I've been requested to lead and coordinate the ceremony. As I said before, I serve in two capacities. My first capacity, I am the much older brother of the bride, while at the same time being the much younger brother-in-law of the groom. Ah. Without further ado, who presents this very young lady to renew her vows?
Her mother-in-law.
Thank you, sir.
Got through that.
I'm going to fall in the sand.
You don't even have shoes on.
Nope.
Very good. Just a little bit of background here. The setting for the initial wedding, it was 1994. Bill Clinton was the President of the United States, and Donald Trump was building Trump Hotel and Tower. In 1994, something that Julie has never used was introduced, the George Foreman Grill. The Zip Drive was introduced. The Dallas Cowboys were Super Bowl champs. And unlike Rodney, there was no winner that year because in baseball there was a strike and no one won the World Series. Who can forget O.J. Simpson? For all you folks with a financial mind, the Dow Jones Industrial Average ended the year at 3,834. And at last look on Friday, it was 25,886. God bless America. How about that? On television. Anybody watch any television here? Seinfeld was watched frequently. ER, Home Improvement, And Roseanne was still on TV and was rated 10th that year. Wonderful movies. At the exact same time, you could see Forrest Gump, The Lion King, Jurassic Park, and Pulp Fiction. And many of these movies have inspired this young couple. They did. Before the wedding, I was with Rodney before the wedding, and he said, "I just can't wait to be king." But the most telling line from that would have been from Forrest Gump. The line, obviously, that Rodney ignored, "Run, Rodney, run." Actually, on a serious note, most telling line from that was, "My mama always said that life was a box full of chocolates. You never know what you're going to get." Some personal family matters here. Rodney, being the gentleman that he is, requested that my father and mother, Eugene and Eleanor, give their permission and blessing. My mother said, "Well, we don't pick our children, so do whatever you want to do." My father was a little bit more, a little higher level of wisdom. He suggested, "She's a very independent young lady. She's strong-minded, and are you really sure?" I'd like to do two very brief items. First of all, read a scripture from the book of Jeremiah, chapter 29, verse 11. "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and to not harm you, and plans to give you hope and a future." You know, we're all encouraged by leaders who stir us to move ahead. Someone who believes we can accomplish the task that we are assigned. Our God is that kind of leader who will lead us all the way. God knows our future, and His plans for us are good and full of hope. His plans for us do not guarantee that we'll be spared pain, suffering, or hardship. But as you can see here, our God sees us through. God has blessed Rodney and Julie with blessings beyond even their wild imagination in 1994. Their greatest blessings, the two young ladies here and the gentleman on my left, Azure, Indigo, and Raymond. They are beautiful youth, they have kind hearts, and they want to serve and help people. Raymond is very funny and wise. Just before the ceremony, he said, "You're the funniest guy I've ever met, Uncle Ed." So it's getting all better with that. This couple to my left has traveled the world. They've been scuba diving with sharks and have yet to be eaten. They've climbed mountains and traveled the globe. Business and finance has been kind to them. They have been blessed beyond their wildest dreams from 25 years ago. But their greatest blessing today is all of you folks here today. Friends that have traveled from near and far to share in this. Another blessing they have is that special love that the two of them have between a man and a woman that can endure 25 years and last into eternity. There are thousands of songs about love, love poems, and thousands of books. But Rodney and Julie have found a love that we all look to experience and may never find. The last comment talks about the future. This is a young couple. The future is bright and they have much to be done. Today is more than just a celebration of 25 years. It's the opportunity to thank God for fulfilling His promises. May Rodney and Julie look forward to experience even greater blessings in the future. And finally, I'd like to close with a scripture from the book of Ecclesiastes. It goes something like this. "Two are better than one because they have a good return for their labor." You had a good return so far? No comments. It's all good. "If either of them falls down, one can help the other up. But pity to anyone who falls and has no one to help them up. Also, if the two of them lie down together..." Have you ever been lying down? I'm sorry, it's a family show.
At least three times.
"They will keep warm. But how can they keep warm? Though one may be overpowered, two can defend themselves. A cord of three stands and is not quickly broken." At this time, I'd like to invite up a dear friend of more than 20 years, Chuck Constantino, for some kind words. Chuck, come on up here.
Yes, Chuck.
We love you, Chuck.
We love you, Chuck.
We love you, Chuck.
Hello, everyone. Julie asked me to read this poem. And
and it's by Robert Frost. And it's called The Road Not Taken. Two roads diverged in a yellow wood. And sorry, I could not travel both and be one traveler. Long I stood, looked down one as far as I could to where it bent into the undergrowth. Then took a look at the other, just as fair, and having perhaps the better claim, because it was grassy and wanted wear. Though as for that, the passing there had worn them really about the same. And both that morning equally lay in leaves no steps had trodden. Oh, I kept the first one for another day. Yet knowing how days lead to days, I doubted if I'd ever come back. I shall be telling this with a sigh one day. Somewhere ages and ages hence, two roads diverged into a wood, and I took the one less traveled, and that made all the difference. I've known them for a long time.
A long time.
In comparison to many other married couples I know, Julie and Ron have a very close partnership and a very successful marriage. The road they took is different from the one that most couples do. I believe the road they took is one full of genuine respect and deep love. Similar to the two paths in the poem, they are very different as people, but equally attractive in their own way. The key to their success, I believe, is that rather than trying to change each other, they learn to know each other and respect their differences and learn from them and grow from them. Yet at the same time, encouraging each other to fulfill their dreams and ambitions with the assurance that their love was constant. That's a very rare thing in marriage, I think, these days. As a result, both of them are personally happier and professionally more successful than when I met them 28 years ago. So let's congratulate them for a successful marriage. And let's pray that they have many more years together.
Thank you, Chuck. That's beautiful. Thank you, sir.
Very good. At this time, it's my pleasure to introduce the two daughters of the bride and groom, Azure and Indigo. And you have it says here, a scripture. Is that true? The scripture is in the room. Okay. And that's okay.
Because we'll leave it there.
Well, the beauty of it is, do you have your cell phone there? The beauty of technology, we can forget things in the room and still not miss a beat. We can fill for a few moments while Google tells us where we should have brought from the room. And it's all about preparation, as you said, Rodney. Now, Rodney, while we're doing this, he has something to say. He has four cards.
I only have three for this one.
Three cards with multicolor in an order so as to be fully prepared for this endeavor. But he is showing the organization of his maturity, and it should be commended as such.
This by itself should say something about me.
We're all good.
It's fine.
Did you find them?
No, it's in the room.
Would you like me to go first?
Go right ahead, Dad.
This is pretty spontaneous, guys.
Spontaneous, but with a mic. Yeah.
All right. I'll be spontaneous with the mic. So, how many people are fans of Jimmy Stewart? How many people are fans of Henry Fonda? Now, this is a tough question. How many people know the movie Cheyenne Social Club? Yeah. Couple people know the movie Cheyenne Social Club. Well, I have to read this one because I'll just screw up Henry Fonda's lines. But Henry was a little guy named Harley Sullivan. And Harley and Jimmy Stewart, who was known as John, they were cowboys in Dallas, just working the ranch. And John gets a letter from his attorney way up in Denver or somewhere, Cheyenne. And it says, you've now inherited the Cheyenne Social Club. And without saying a word to Harley, who he had been riding with for years, he just jumps on his horse and starts riding away. And poor Harley is like, where are you going, John? Well, Harley, being the good soldier, just jumps on his horse and starts following along. And if any of you know the movie, Harley can't keep his mouth shut. For 1,000 miles, Harley is talking and talking and talking and telling stories about his life. Well, there's one story that Julie and I always laugh at each other about, and it's absolutely hilarious. So this is Harley talking about his cousin, Jim. Okay. Jim, he sure was a fine figure of a man, but he fell to pieces when he got married. He got fat. His hair started falling out. His teeth went bad. And this is the important quote. The worse looking he got, the better looking she got. And I don't mean she weren't no vampire, nothing like that. At least no ways nobody could prove it. But Lord mercy, the better looking or the worse looking he got, the better looking she got. And all I can tell you is just captures the essence of it.
Amen, Brother Rodney, amen. Okay?
Yeah.
Here, I'll hold the flowers. Okay. You hold the mic.
Okay, so this is from Corinth, the book of Corinthians.
You look very nice with your flowers.
If I speak in the tongues of men and the angels but have not love, I am a noisy gong or clanging cymbal. I have prophetic powers, and I understand all mysteries really bad. If I give away all I have, and I deliver up my body be burned, but have not love, I gain nothing. Love is patient, like when mom spends hours out on the tennis courts. Love does not envy or boast unless we're playing cards, Dad. Love is not arrogant, once again with the cards, or rude. It does not insist on its own way or is not irritable or resentful, like when Dad ditches cleaning the kitchen to go play with the dogs. It does not rejoice at wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Like our latest legal infraction.
Please.
Love never ends. As for prophecies, they will pass away. As for tongues, they will not cease. As for knowledge, it will pass away. For we know in part, and we prophesy in part. But when the perfect one comes, the partial will pass away.
Thank you. At this time, I'm going to hand the microphone over to the bride. Now, the bride's somewhat shy and reserved.
Oh, wait. I got two more things.
Oh. Do
you have her permission?
Huh?
He can go first.
I don't want to get between
he's got two more cards.
It's all
good.
I got
two more cards for this, man. I worked hard on these
cards. It's all good.
You want to go or you want me to go?
No, I'm going to have you come back because I know you got something really nice to say and I can't wait to hear it.
By the way, you can tell everybody they can come on down.
Come on down. It's no big deal. No big deal.
You made all this drive. Come on down.
We're just waiting for the rain. So, I don't imagine, there are a lot of people here I don't know that I hope to meet tonight because most of them are Julie's friends because all my friends are dying or dead by now. I don't know.
We're here.
Well,
hey, come on.
But most of you don't know how we met. And I tell this story because it just shows you how the smallest things in life can change your life. So in 1990, I moved four times. I moved from Denver to Washington, D.C., to Connecticut, and then to Pittsburgh in a span of about 12 to 14 months, okay? Ending up in Pittsburgh was like a complete random walk. I knew one person in the whole town. And there was a little bar in this town called Studebaker's. And so I went to Studebaker's one night. It was in July of 1990, and there was this 5'9" blonde in a cheerleader outfit. Funny why I'd be interested in that, who knows? But she waits on me. She brings me the wrong drink, and I don't say a word because I'm just still looking at the 5'9" blonde waiting on me. And for the next really 9 months, now a little 8 months or so, I just kept going back to that bar and drinking a drink I did not like because I really enjoyed watching the 5'9". Absolutely petrified to ever say a word to her. One point I actually gave her my business card. And I didn't think much of it. And she finally figured out what my name was about 6 months into that whole trip. Well, sometime in early December, she broke up with her boyfriend and she went back with her college roommates and they were all trying to cheer her up. And so they went through her deck of business cards that she had collected working this restaurant bar over all of those years, dealing them out like a little Shuffle 52 thing, right? Uh-huh. How do small things change your life? She pulled my card out of that deck, called me up, and asked me out. That was December 20, 1990. When I picked myself up off the floor, I said stutteringly, absolutely, and we had a date on, it was December 20th, and if you can believe it, from December 20th until this day, we've really never been apart. So for all that time, and for all of those events that have to happen, that one little business card and that one little moment in time is the reason the two of us are together all these years later. So it was absolutely a fabulous thing for me. And the last thing I want to say is just a promise to you. I love you. I'll always love you. I've made 1,000 decisions before that date in 1990. I've made 1,000 after that, but the best decision I ever made was to ask you to marry me. You've been the most special thing in my life, other than these three that have come along the way. But I just couldn't be more blessed. And I thank you for being my life partner.
Okay, well, he ad-libbed that. I had to write it down. Because I've been dealing with this for months now. Oh. And I've had so many thoughts and so many things going through my head. And I finally said, if I don't write it down, I'm going to forget something important. But 25 years ago, I was so young. So young.
Really good.
And you came along and were my knight in shining armor. 25 years later, not so young anymore, but still, every day, you are my knight in shining armor. Everyone thought we were crazy when we got married. Most people didn't give us 2 years, tops. Insane. But no one knew or understood what to happen to bring us together. Every victory, every defeat, every closed door, and every opportunity all led you to me. When I stand here and contemplate the series of events that needed to occur to bring me to you, I stand here in utter amazement of God's plan and the way He works in our lives. We've meant to be together since the beginning of time. I've known that since the day I met you. I was born for you. I was born for us. And when you know that, it makes the hard times a little bit easier. And we've had some and weathered some incredibly horrific storms in 25 years. Neither of us are perfect, but together, we're perfect together. I knew that the first night we went out. Our relationship flows. We don't have to work on it. While we never do anything quite like anybody else, and for the way we do things, it wouldn't have worked for anybody else. It works for us. The only thing about the future that terrifies me is that we just won't have enough time. There will never be enough time. Till death do us part is simply not long enough. I will follow you and love you from here to the ends of the earth and into heaven and infinity and beyond. I love you so much. Thank you for choosing me.
Oh.
Woo-hoo.
Could have ruined the makeup.
Move to the middle.
Move to the middle?
Yeah, every time.
You want me to move over too?
Okay. At this time, we're going to have the official vow renewal.
Oh my God.
Yes. So you want to go first? You want to go first?
Well, he was my lawfully wedded wife the first time.
Okay,
so.
We're going to go. I, Rodney. Take you, Julie. To be my wife. To have and to hold from this day forward. For better or worse.
For richer.
For poorer.
In sickness and in health.
To love you.
To cherish you.
And to forgive you.
Until we're parted by death.
That's my solemn vow. And you, Julie, do you take this man, Rodney, to be your husband?
I do.
We'll try it again. I take this name, okay.
I take this man, Rodney, to be my husband.
Very good. To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
For better or worse. For richer, for poorer. In sickness and health.
To love and cherish.
To honor.
And obey.
Until we are parted by death.
This is my solemn vow.
I tried, Rodney.
I didn't get it the last time either.
At this point in the service, there's a sand ceremony.
Yes.
Do you need the mic? Here, I'll take the flowers. I'll take the notes.
Thank you. Usually for the sand ceremony, it's about the two people coming together as one. But since we've been married for such a long time, and the kids are starting to head out and get older and be on their way.
2020.
This is not just a commitment between the two of us. This is a commitment to the five of us. That no matter where they go, no matter what they do,
okay, no. We
always thought we'll be together and be integrated as one. So if you want to come on up here.
Who gets what?
Okay, we have Raymond is red.
Oh, thank you.
Raymond's red. Rodney, I gave you black because you look so good in black. Indigo, azure, and champagne. Tina, that is so appropriate. All right.
Do we
pour it all together?
Is that gonna work? Yeah.
Should. I'll just go last.
Nice, Ash.
Yeah, I'm good. Yeah, that really worked out.
I'll let you go. Oh, God,
wow,
what a mess.
People really. Your shakiness is really.
It's not
all right,
our
go
fault.
Ahead, Ray.
You guys were pushing me out of the way.
Does this sound familiar?
Yeah, this is what dinner is most of.
Go ahead, Ray. Top it off with a lovly red. That's hilarious.
Yeah, it
works. Oh, my won't fit.
That's all right. You top, I top.
There you go.
All right.
This worked out well.
And this we will keep forever on the mantle.
Okay.
And we'll have it forever.
It looks great.
It's so pretty.
All of us together.
Didn't work out well at all.
As family forever.
Oh my God. Yeah. Wow. Very nice, Andrew.
Good thing this wasn't formal or anything.
Good. The final item I have under here is a statement of unity. You don't know what that is either?
Nope, I think we just did that.
No, okay. Very good. What I'd like to do now is, once again, on behalf of Julie and Rodney and their entire family, thank you each and all for being here today. As I mentioned previously, their greatest gift are the people here that have loved them and cherished them through all these years. Following the formal ceremony, this ceremony, it's not formal. We're going to go up on the veranda for
cocktails,
followed by dinner, and we'll have a chance to reacquaint with Julie, Rodney, and the rest of the family.
Do I get to give him a kiss this time?
Ladies and gentlemen, may I introduce for the multiple time, Rodney and Julie Warren Feltz!
That was better.
The first time.
It always is.
All right.
Ready?
Oh, okay. and it didn't even rain on you.
I told you it wasn't going to.
For the folks that put this event together. So most of you guys don't know what I was like back in 1994. The only thing I really remember about that wedding was saying I do. Anything before or after is just a complete blur. What I have seen over the last 6 months from the group that put this event together is absolutely amazing. And I want to call two people out in particular. First of all, Linda, wherever she may be. I keep hearing the hair is only done every 5 weeks, but I gotta tell you, I don't buy it. The second person I have to acknowledge tonight is a woman that has been tireless in putting this event together. She's coordinated everything, she's sweated every detail, and if she could hit a drop shot, she would be perfect. But that's Miss Monica Dowd, and she pulled everything. My second thank you tonight is to my lovely wife. I don't know how many of you guys have actually participated in weddings where you actually did something. I didn't. I just, for 6 months, she you may not know this, she finished her MBA in December, and apparently, apparently didn't have anything to do and decided this was a good idea. And I have never seen so many moving parts. I mean, it is really astonishing to me. I don't remember any of this during my first wedding, but I was wide awake for most of this one. And that's hard to believe, because in this case, I'm not. But anyway, she did an astounding job. And what you don't understand about Julia is that her planning skills are, how shall we say this? Not at the top of most levels of people I would hire. But she coordinated this, she sweated every detail, and it's what I love about her most. It was another surprise. How can she put this together, finish her MBA, play tennis at an A level, take care of these kids, keep me in line, and all of that at one time. So sweetheart, thank you so much for all this. Very, very much. And then finally, for all of you, there just aren't even words. I mean, I don't know how to thank people that show up to an event like this and make it so special for us. I thought a lot about what I would say to you and how I would offer my appreciation. But just to come tonight and just to be here, and some of you from very, very far away, some as far away as Hawaii, believe it or not, but the people that would show up here to share this event with us tonight is something really special. It's something I will always appreciate. I know my family will always appreciate it too, and the kids. And I'm sure all the pictures will summarize it, but all I really want to say is thank you, and I appreciate you sharing this evening with us. Thank you so much.
Folks, now we're going to have a blessing of the meal from Ed. He's over there. He may not need the mic.
I'll take your lunch.
Would you like
it? Oh, I love it. I never brought a mic out of my head.
That's what I said.
Yeah, what? You just don't turn it on there, sir.
There we go. Thank you.
Yeah, We've had some wedding traditions lately. I like to bring my good luck here. So, for example, my socks were the socks from my son's wedding last year, which was really cool. Actually, it wasn't last year. I'm sorry. Thank you, dear, for correcting me. She didn't. This is my lovely wife, Tim. And I also brought, from my daughter's wedding, I brought her husband, Derek. Everything is better with Derek. So when I was asked to the grace, oh gee, what happened there, huh? Improvise. I like that. Anyway, there we go. I had a song I sang at my daughter's wedding. Now when I sang it, I had a pianist and I had a beautiful accompanist, or a female singer with a beautiful voice. So tonight, all you're gonna get is just me without the piano and without the voice. So I'm gonna sing a song you might hear some way. It's called The Prayer. There'll be no Latin or Italian. I'm sorry, there's no Italian. Anybody Italian in the house? There's no Italian. So without further ado, I'm gonna give this a try. I'll pray you be our guide and watch us where we go. And help us to be wise in times when we don't know. Let this be our prayer when we lose our way. Lead us to a place, guide us with your grace, to a place where we'll be safe. I'll pray we'll find your light and hold it in our hearts. When stars go out each night, remind us where you are. Let this be a prayer when shadows fill our day. Lead us to a place, guide us with your grace, to a place where we'll be safe. Let's bow our heads, please. Our kind Heavenly Father, we thank you for this beautiful evening. We thank you for the love that Julie and Robbie have had for 25 years. We thank you for the blessings you've given them. And more importantly, Lord, we thank you for the blessings you'll give them in the future, Lord. Lord, now we thank you for this food. Help us the nourishment of all of our bodies and bless all the hands that prepare, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Well, with that, ladies and gentlemen, dinner is served.
I've never seen two people with more love in their hearts for each other, and they're a perfect example of what we want one day. Like every couple, they have their ups and downs. Okay. When thinking about my parents' relationship, I think of them sitting in the man cave watching Investigation Discovery with margaritas in their hands, cracking jokes for the sole purpose to make each other laugh. When they are together, you can tell that they feel as if half of them is missing and they're doing their best to get through until they're reunited. Anyway, thank you all again for coming, and most of all, thank you my parents for giving us a strong example of love and creating the best environment for us to grow up in. And don't worry, I'll sometimes come visit you next year in college. Oh.
You got it? All right, man.
Hey, everyone. As you guys can already probably piece together, I'm making a toast. I would like this to be dedicated to friends, family, and love. And I say love because That was one of the hardest things to find. And whenever I look at my parents, I can see the hardship and struggle we went through to see that and get that between them. And I see it's just such a special thing between them, and that's just amazing. Anyway, I just wanted to say congratulations, 25 years, and I guess you're just 25 more. Yeah.
Everybody's back when I'm 89.
All right, well, I think we're going to have a little song right now. So we're going to make our way over here to the speakers. We're going to be running out of folks. Oh, my God.
Oh, my
I swear.
right there. Of course, the song she was singing was From the Wedding from 1994. She did a fantastic job. It is hard to get up here and do that. See, I'm nervous. You did it. I can't even sing. Amazing. Well, folks, it is now time for our first dance of the evening for the bride and groom. Ladies and gentlemen, please turn your attention to the center of the dance floor for the bride and groom to have a dance once again.
Give my all to you, you're mine.
right there. We're having a great time watching the movie, too. So.
That's a 10 out of narcissistic side
for me. Oh, yes, for sure.
All right, folks, we're going to have Julie have a dance with her dad at this time. So this song we're about to play is Julie's mom and dad's 25th anniversary song. And now Julie's gonna dance with dad.
I can't remember when you were there, when I didn't care for anyone but you. I swear we've been through everything. There is, can't imagine anything we've missed, can't imagine anything the two of us can't do. Through the years, you've never let me down, you turned my life around. The sweetest days I found with you.
The children are going to come dance with the parents.
Oh yeah.
All right, go ahead, DJ.
Of course,
hey, song from
audience round of applause for all the dancers this evening. And little did they know, but they officially have warmed up the dance floor. It is time to party. Let's go.
Yeah. spring and back like me.
Yeah. professionals out here, I can tell. Professional dancers. Hey, you know what? Stop right there. Hold on. Stop right there. Stop. Music. I know what we're going to do. That song, I can see the skill. That song is too slow. So we're going to do the same dance to a faster song. 1995. The song is called Space Jam. Go DJ. Sir.
Get up, it's sir. On the sled.
No big deal. Nobody's watching, bro. Me and you. This song was playing when the Penguins won the Stanley Cup. Squad.
Man, come on out. Come on out.
The Platinum Band.
We'll line up.
Time.
Folks, when the bride is on the floor, you should be on the floor. As you're an indie. As you're an indie. Let's go, y'all. Come on. Clap your hands. I know you know this.
Clap your hands.
Wait, listen. It tells you what to do.
Clap your hands. All right, now. We're going to do the basic step. To the left.
Everybody face the ocean. Face the ocean.
What up this time? Let's jump.
Stomp your right.
Left foot, let's jump. Cha-cha, real smooth.
One step up and one back.
Turn it out.
Hey, turn to your left.
To the left.
Move to the left.
Take it back now, y'all.
Back up.
One hop this time. Right foot, let's jump.
Stomp your right.
Left foot, let's jump. Cha-cha now, y'all. Now it's time to get funky. To the right now.
Turn your
right. To the left. Take it back now, y'all.
Come on.
One hop this time. One hop this time. Right foot, two stumps. Left foot, two stumps. Slide to the left. Slide to the right. Crisscross. Crisscross. Cha-cha, real smooth.
Step up, step back.
Let's go to work.
Turn to the left.
To the left. Take it back now, y'all.
Step back.
Two hops this time.
Bounce back.
Two hops this time. Right foot, two stumps. Left foot, two stumps. Hands on your knees. Hands on your knees.
Shake it like a salt shaker. Shake it like a
fucking whip.
I do it like this, look.
Yeah. Come on. Cha-cha now, y'all.
One step up and one back is the cha-cha.
Turn it out.
Hey, turn to your left.
To the left.
Move to your left.
Take it back now, y'all. This time.
One, two.
Right foot, let's stop. Left foot, let's stop. Right foot again. Left foot again. Right foot, let's stop. Left foot, let's stop. Freeze.
Everybody
clap your hands.
Everybody clap your hands and everybody make some noise because Julie and Ronnie have been married for 25 years. Hello, hello.
Can you go down low? To the floor?
I can't get up.
How low can you go? Can you bring it to the top? Like it never stop. Can you bring it to the top? One hop. Right foot now. Left foot now, y'all. Cha-cha, real smooth.
Play some music.
Turn it out.
Hey, turn to your left.
To the left.
Move to your left.
Take it back now, y'all.
Straight back.
One hop this time. One hop this time. Reverse.
Jump on it, if you say it, say it, and feel me. Keep getting on it.
something like this. About to sing? Oh, well, he chose him a horse. Very nice.
Wait.
also have a lot of cake, guys. It's mint chocolate chip cake.
Take my horse to the old town road. thank you, lady. Do it, thank you, lady.